you should wear goggles.
Just came along. For the first time, I thought there is such a thing as too young.
Cliff.
Henry, this fine young man is called Samson, and he was just showing me his tattoo of the Sacré-Cœur. Isn't it magnificent?
How did you get here?
Oh, I was just saying to Freddie, I've met all your flatmates. It's great.
Cliff's been very generous.
But your sister phoned. She was checking out the court actions on this address on your behalf. And when I asked her why, she was being a bit shifty. So I phoned you at work and they said you were unavailable. So I just bluffed it and I said, I'm his solicitor. Put me through.
He's not really my solicitor. He just did my house about 8 years ago.
And then they said you were going to pass me through to legal. And I said, why? And they said, because you've been suspended. And I said, yes! I said, I know! It's outrageous! How dare you! I didn't have a fucking clue.
That's brilliant.
But then they said you'd left a forwarding address. Well, look at that. The Calico Warehouse. Hello.
Do you know what I love about the modern world? Everyone knows every fucking thing. Oh, Jesus, Cliff.
You've had a time, haven't you?
Yeah. I'm not going home. I said to Lance, I'm not ready, it's just dinner. He's booked that saisons at the Ramsay, if you know it.
Christ, I want to fuck that, Freddy.
I know.
I mean, bend him over and fuck that arse all night long. Can you imagine his face when he comes?
So do you be drinking?
Oh, it's just the one. Oh, you've got it so right, Henry. Leave your boring boyfriend for that hot, fit fucker. It's inspired.
It's not like that, not really. I'm not sleeping with him.
Oh, I know you're not.
He's only 24. It'd be ridiculous.
Not for me.
Right. Time to go. Where you parked, I'll walk you there.
We can leave them to it, the young things. They don't need us.
Mr. B, can you still afford those windows? Because Scotty said the check's okay, but she had to put down 100 quid in cash. Can you pay it back?
That's what I said. Burnation Street and all that. Deep cleaning at murder scenes.
The corner's a third of this size, but we still pay Roderick 400 quid. The whole thing's weird.
Did you really?
Knock, knock. Cliff, let's go.
Freddie was just saying he was training to be an architect.
Brilliant. Architect and chef. He's like a Renaissance man.
What makes you think I'm a chef? It's a cook, chill kitchen. All we do is heat things up.
So what happened with the architecture?
Got chucked out. It's my own fault. I'm too busy getting pissed.
Anyway, we're off.
I'm going to stay.
No, come on. We can go together.
No, you're going to be late. Don't worry about me. I'll be fine. Freddie can look after me. Off you go, Henry. Turn around. Bye-bye.
I can help you with the stairs.
Oh, just shut up and go.
Right, then. I remember what I said. Be careful with that drink. Cliff's got a bit of a problem. Big problem, really. Lifelong problem. And you watch out, Freddie. Cliff said he's dying to see your cum face.
Do you, don't you? Go home. I thought it best to tell you before the funeral, just in case it goes public, but I've been informed that Daniel Coltrane has instructed a new defence team.
What for? But he confessed. He said that he did it. He said so.
I know, yeah.
He was the one who called the police. He sat there with Lance's body for 3 hours. He told them.
He's now claiming provocation.
Oh, Jesus.
He's saying that Lance made a pass at him and he lashed out.
Gay panic.
The defence is known as gay panic. The court won't recognise it. Homosexual panic is not allowed as defence of its own.
But this means we're going to trial. If he changes his story, there's got to be a trial. Is that right?
The thing is, he's insane. I mean, genuinely, he's in a state of collapse. Tomorrow he might say something completely different.
Can he stop the funeral? Are you kidding?
No, he can't. The body's been released. He can't do that.
But if it does go to court, he can say all this out loud. He can say it was Lance's fault. Could it work? Is there any chance it could actually work?
No. Although he claims sexual assault, we might be looking at manslaughter, not murder.
What's that for?
What?
Why are you looking at me?
I can go and see him. I know he's turned down your request. Unless, Henry, you want to try and...
I don't want to see him, no.
Understood. But I could get to see him. To represent you, if you want. And obviously I could take a statement, have a briefcase with me, files and a pen. Because solicitors get searched entering a prison just like everyone else, but I'd still have a pen. Because a pen is all I need, really. I think it would take me a second to lean across and insert the pen through his throat. Right here, at the base, straight through to the spine. I could do that. He'd bleed out in seconds. Dead. So? That's what I'll do. With your permission.
Yeah, absolutely. It would be excellent.
Studying economics in MMU. Wish me luck, I'm going in.
Too late.
Doesn't do over 21.
Ooh! Oh, it's not over. I thought we'd seen the last of this. Funerals at too young an age, I thought we'd... Tell you what, you know the worst thing about getting old?
Oh, don't, Cliff, not today.
Hairs. We get hairs.
That's nothing new, we all get hairs.
No, I mean hairs on your cock. Not on the base, but on the shaft, like halfway down. Sticking out the middle like a branch on a mug tree. And the older you get, the more they sprout. Sticking right out of your cock. And they're long. And they grow fast, like a bolted lettuce. They just appear out of nowhere, overnight. Bang! Cock hairs. Halfway down! Protruding!
It's a stray hair, isn't it?
Give it a pull.
Right.
I'm fine. I'm just.
Oh yeah.
What? Feel as if I've eaten too many eggs. Everybody wants to see me cry. They're just waiting, like they need it. Well, they can bugger off. Last night I thought I was going to drown.
Sorry, move on. Told you that place was dodgy. It turns out you're an allotment scheme. It's recession economics starting in New York. Property gets frozen in dispute, so you fill it with tenants, the kind of tenants who don't ask too many questions. Keep the rent low, so no one asks for a contract. Then you stand back and you watch them flourish with their iPads and their smartphones and their widescreen TVs. And then you harvest them. All of your stuff will be on sale in a pub in Alto by 12 o'clock, and there is nothing you can do about it. In 6 months' time, they'll start again. Plant new seeds.
I've got nothing left.
You're a fucking disaster. Duty calls.
Fuck up. You fucking.
I don't deserve that. You're not bad. Oh, by the way, did you notice?
What?
No crutches.
Oh, well done.
Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Fuck me, Henry. Your sister knows some tricks. I'm raw.
Where are the kids?
They got ripped off their tits and they're sitting on the roof. Where do you think they are? Bobby came and took them home about midnight. And you kissed him. Now fuck off and get me a coffee.
Morning.
Hi there.
Yes, we did.
Why not me? Why not me?
Here you go.
You gotta realize all your responsibility is. You gotta get out to work and face reality.
And this is my representative, Mr. Costello, Cliff, Mr. Pablo, and this is Mr. Baxter. He's employed within your catering facilities. I brought him here today as the official spokesman for the gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, and other collective.
Right, that's, fine. I wasn't aware that, not that that's a problem, but can I ask why?
At my request, Mr. Costello has discovered that...
Including my client, Mr. Best, you've suspended 17 members of staff from 2010 to the present day.
Can I ask how many of them were gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgendered or other?
Now, as you know, I'm not in a position to say. An employee's sexuality is entirely private, but are you claiming that our treatment of you was based on your sexual orientation?
Well, is it?
Not at all. Not in any way.
So, if we use the tribunal to ask those 17 about their sexuality, what do you think we'll find?
I wasn't aware that we were having a tribunal, but are you saying you're the only homosexual we've suspended?
Well, am I?
Can I point out, if you were the only homosexual out of 17, that would prove we're not biased.
So all those others are straight?
I'm not saying that at all. It's perfectly possible that there are more gay or lesbian, bisexual, trans or... other members of staff amongst the 17.
So you're saying there are others?
No, that's not what I'm saying.
Then what is it? Are you saying they're all gay or lesbian or bisexual or transgendered or other?
Well, no, they couldn't be.
Oh.
Ouch. Why couldn't they be?
I mean, they wouldn't be.
Why wouldn't they?
It's not likely.
Why not?
17 of them.
Why not?
It's just not, is it?
Seems to me that you have clearly, on the record just now, speculated about the sexuality of your workforce out loud. So, any further conversation is moot. Mr. Costello?
Mr. Pablo, on behalf of Mr. Best, I look forward to the tribunal, because the law is magnificent in this regard. It's not up to us to prove homophobia. It's up to you to prove homophobia does not exist. Best of luck. Thank you. Unless...
He did it!
Made it return to work!
I stared him down.
Reinstated, plus an apology, and I'm going to ask for promotion.
Well?
That's brilliant. Well done.
I've made a big bowl of couscous.
What is it? What's wrong?
Dean's got some news.
We found him.
Found who?
The boy. Because all those rumours I was talking about, they turned out to be true. And we found him.
Now, we just need to be sure. Don't worry. We're all friends. We just need to be absolutely certain of the facts. So, this is the man?
Yeah. That's him.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So what happened?
It's like I told him, it was about a few months ago, and...
His defence is saying that on the night he killed Lance, he lashed out and panicked because it was the first time he'd ever been with a gay man.
Well, that's not true.
Exactly.
I'll take you to the police. I'll help you. I'll stay with you. Is that all right? Will you do it?
Okay.
Right, I'm off for a wank. I really am. I've discovered a thing for rucksacks. You know when you're looking through safe for work stuff, and every now and then you find a photo of a man with a rucksack? It's the straps on bare skin. I had no idea. It's a brand new fetish. Don't even know where it came from. Maybe I was molested by a hitchhiker when I was 6.
I used to think Lance was stupid. No offence.
That is a bit offensive.
I never liked Lance. He never liked me. We were perfect equals.
But I thought, he's an idiot. Because you had 9 years with him. But none of that's true, is it?
Oh, give him a break.
There's nothing innocent about you. and I offered you sex. You manoeuvred me into that position and then you turned me down. You're a genius.
Right, Freddy, what have you got stuck up your arse tonight?
You, if you're lucky.
Wasn't that simple?
This one is this.
Okay. I'll stay up for a bit.
Well, I can see myself out. Off you go. Right, that's me done. Okay, I can tidy up if you want, won't take 10 minutes. No harm in being polite, I suppose, just this once. Ooh, well, don't mind if I do. Where is it?
No. What if she asks for Yvonne and Yvette is literally standing there but she doesn't ask?
I think we should give it a break now. What do you think, Scotty?
Hello? Sorry to bother you, I was wondering, can I speak to Yvonne, please? I can. No, just tell her it's Scotty. From customs. He's going to get her. What do I say?
Well, tell her you love her.
No, tell her you want to talk to her about exporting china plates from Spain. Rare china plates. And, I don't know, you're worried about the euro.
Hello? Is this Yvonne?